How to import files from Blender to CATIA V5. Okay, so if we want to transfer a model from Blender to CATIA, we can use this workflow. Here's a 3D model of a hammer modeled in Blender. This is the wireframe. Let's see how we can transfer this model within CATIA. So we'll go to File, Export. I will export the file as a wave. Front OBJ. I will go to the desktop and I will create a new folder. I will call it for now 1. Here we can define the scale. So if you want to prepare this for 3D printing, we can either scale it here, but we can do that in CATIA also. Also, we can define the app axis. I will go with I for this model. Okay, so I have the folder selected. I can export the model. The export is completed. So within CATIA we'll go to Start, Shape, Imagine a Shape. I will create a new part. After that, Insert, Import, Import Subdivision Meshes. And I will select that hammer. It was folder 1. We can see that we have the 3D model as an OBJ file, 2 megabytes. So now the software will convert that to an Imagine Shape editable surface. I can also define the scale again now with addition. I can set the import scale, but I will leave it like this. First I will want to measure it, and after that we decide how much we will scale it. So press OK. Now we will have the file imported as an editable subdivision, similar to the one that you can create within Imagine Shape. For this example, I will want my part to be a, let's say, a closed solid with material on the inside. For that, I will go to Start, Mechanical Design, Part Design. And over here we have this option, it's called Closed Surface. You can find it up at Insert, Surface Base Features, Close Surface. Then we will define the mesh and click OK. Now the software will convert that mesh. So for example, if I will hide that, I can only see the subdivision element. So within Part Design we can do a section cut, dynamic sectioning, and I see that the model imported from Blender as an OBJ doesn't have material on the inside, so it isn't a closed surface. This is the one. I will rename it imported surface. So for that, Alt Enter. Over here at Features, imported mesh. Okay, I will hide that for now, and I will display this model. So this is the closed surface created earlier. So the advantage is that over here, if I go into dynamic sectioning, I will see that I have material on the inside of this part. So now I can start and do some modeling, but first let's measure this hammer. To do that, I can do this measure like this, not measure inertia, measure with the ruler, measure between, let's say, 1 point over there, 1 point at the back. And I see that the hammer has 7 millimeters. Okay, so I will want to scale this, let's say, 50 times. To do the scaling, I will select the closed surface, then go up to Insert, Transformation Features, and I will go with Scaling. If I want, I can go with Affinity, and I can scale it on different axes with different values, but I want to maintain the shape, so I will go with Scaling. For reference, I will select a point 0, 0, so it will be the middle of the reference. After that, I set the ratio. I want to scale it 50 times. I will click OK. Now the software will do the scaling. Okay, it goes a bit slower, it doesn't usually like model with so many vertices. So this is the difference between CATIA and Blender. CATIA doesn't use polygons to model, it uses curves, but we can do this type of conversions. This is the scale model. Now if I want to, let's say, make a cut over here, I can define a new plane. As a plane type, I will go to normal or tangent to curve. Tangent for curve is easier in this situation. I will select the surface and I need to define a point. So create a point and create a point on that surface. After that, click OK. And now if I will click OK again, I have this plane one defined. So I can go in that plane. Let's say I want to do a cut. I can define a circle, put a radius, say 15. And now I have the possibility to cut the material. Okay, so I want to go up to next, but on the other side. I will go with reverse direction, not reverse side. Now it will only leave me the cut. So since the model has been imported, it takes a bit to process. Okay, I want to reverse side, I want to reverse that direction of the cut. Let's see if up to next we'll be able to cut this model. Okay, it managed to cut it. Let's go within a section. So it has made the cut up to next. It had reached this interior element. Okay, so it worked as a normal cut part, even though it was imported. Now let's see if I want to create the middle part. I will define a new sketch. I will create the shape. And again, I can go and extrude that part. Let's say I want to go 200 millimeters, and on the other direction, I want to go 700. Okay, maybe 200 is a bit too much on the top. Leave it only to 100. Okay, so here's the part converted. Again, if I will go back to wireframe, I will see that the converted element has a geometry, a really complex mesh like this, while the other element has only the splines that define that surface. Okay, so if you model something into Blender and you want to, let's say, have more precise measurements, maybe you want to 3D print it, you can import it in CATIA like this. So I hope this helped. Also, if you have any suggestions for other videos like this regarding 3D conversion between different software solution, leave a comment in the section below.